Looking for a new car or truck? TheAutoChannel.com has the most complete and up-to-date pricing, vehicle specifications, and reviews.
Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to Maranello. Today is a special day for us. It's one of those days that you will remember for a series of reasons. First of all, because we're here to officially present FF today. During the last weeks, we published some photographs and released some information, but today, for the first time, together with you, we will have an opportunity to see the details and present this new extraordinary model that we're about to introduce onto the marketplace. The second reason why today is a special day is that we have the possibility of hosting friends from all over the world, you, and hosting you in our home, Maranello. This combination of facts is not accidental. It was deliberately so. During the presentations, you'll discover that FF is perhaps one of the most innovative cars, breaking with the past, unprecedentedly so. But it is a car that, in spite of this, has the Ferrari DNA. It was important to stress the link between the company and the area, Maranello, but also the future, with the need to be innovative and bring something new to the marketplace. Welcome the protagonist of this evening. So welcome to FF.
Buonasera.
Good evening. Good evening, everybody, and welcome to all of you.
Really a great pleasure to have all of you here tonight to show a very unusual Ferrari, extremely innovative, looking ahead, finally something that it's extremely important for us. Una macchina nuova.
A new car, a technologically innovative car, a car which intends to be a different Ferrari for different Ferrari owners. I would like not only us to sort of baptize this car. De Simone is here. He tested it in Patagonia, Finland, and Sweden. He really deserves an applause for his hard work. And together with him, we have young Dario Benuzzi. When we tried the car, he told me, you know, look here, look there. And I must say that they did a tremendous work. Mr. Felisa will speak about the technological innovations and characteristics of this car. We must thank him too. We must thank him because behind him, there are many men and women from Ferrari that work for such an extraordinary product. Because behind an extraordinary product, there are extraordinary people. Thanks, Mr. Felisa, very much, and congratulations. The first customer will be him. He has not yet decided the color. We've got six extraordinary colors, all new. We've got three here. You'll see three more later. I always listen to him when he tests the first time, tests a car the first time. Thank you, Piero, because when he says that the car is right, I can be on the safe side. And above all, Piero told me something that I must repeat. First of all, I'd like to thank Pininfarina, but Piero told me my father would have approved a project like this because it is a project that looks ahead. It breaks with the past, but it really represents a true Ferrari. It's extreme in its performance and driving emotions. It's a fantastic car. Here we've got our two pilots who are on the eve of a very important year. They are working hard with Formula One. They're making the first tests. The Grand Prix in Bahrain will not take place, but the one in Australia will. Well, you know, we have a family father on the one hand and a young husband on the other hand. So I'd like to give them the floor, because by giving them the floor, we also wish them every success for an important season. We have Stefano Domenicali, the head of Gestione Sportiva. It's a season during which we want to do well and be successful, and everyone is working hard at this. So really, good luck. Good evening, everybody. It's really very nice to be here at the presentation of this beautiful car. It's different from the others. It's got a lot of room inside for a father like me. It's a perfect Ferrari where I can take my wife, my son, it's a spectacular car. I'm very happy. It's a beautiful evening. I'm really happy to be here for this presentation, and I do hope that this year in Formula One will be a successful one for Ferrari. Well, he said he will take his family for a drive. You know, to him this means driving at 300 kilometers an hour. Enjoy the drive. I'm also very happy to be here. Good evening to everybody. We're here at the presentation of a beautiful, innovative car. I'm not as old as Felipe. I want more performance from a car. And I think this car can offer high performance levels. We can't forget that it has more than 600 HP. So it's an extreme car you can use in all conditions, with snow, rain, in the mountains. In the past, it was difficult to use it in these conditions. To me, in Switzerland, it's going to be a very useful car. So I have to talk to the chairman, to the president. Now, before giving the floor to Mr. Felisa for a more detailed description of the car, I'd like to ask Dario Benuzzi, who worked on so many Ferraris, really in the past 20 years together, we've made a lot of cars, beautiful ones with high performance levels, winning cars. Dario, please tell us about three elements that satisfied you when developing this car, the three main characteristics, the three best characteristics of FF, in your opinion. Well, above all, it was an interesting project, a highly satisfactory project. The main thing is that drivability is excellent for this car. It's got great performance. Above all, we have been very careful about the most important thing, which is pleasant driving, but with a high level of safety. Piero, well, you drove some kilometers with this car. Please tell us your impressions. Well, I'm really in line with Dario Benuzzi. He likes sitting next to me when we test cars and trusts me a lot. The great level of safety in this car is a great feature. You never know when it goes with two or four driving wheels. The electronic control system gives you high confidence. It gives you a sense of controlling the car. You can use it fast, slow, but it never betrays you. And that's a great thing. As Luca said, well, my father would have liked it. He liked extreme cars, but always drove 2+2 cars. He would have liked this one, certainly, for sure. Well, to end, this is a car that developed out of a blank sheet. It developed out of the idea of combining 599, which is a two-seater race car, with an innovative car, one which is pleasant to drive, a car with exceptional performance, a car to which we have given a lot of attention, first of all in terms of innovative technology and also in terms of cooperation with the best technology partners in the world. It was tested in extreme conditions for many kilometers, but also inside there are many important details, and the roominess is also very important. As Mr. Galliera said, the car has a luggage compartment which is greater and larger than four-door sedans. It is a car that we present with many interior alternatives, with many different materials and different ideas. It's a car that you can tailor make, that you can really customize. It is a car which keeps all the tradition, the history, the temperament, the character of Ferrari. However, looking forward, because people buying such a car, may have two children and may enjoy the car either alone or with the family, yet with exciting driving performance. I hope you like this car. It's a pleasure for us to show you the cars. Afterwards, you can touch them, you can open them, you can assess them. Thank you for being here. Thank you for having this close relationship with the company. To us, the relationship with you, with the people selling Ferrari, with owners, with our clients, with our collectors, is really something important. Very well. Good evening also on my behalf. I think you have already started to know FF. What I can say is that to us, it was a challenging project because, as usual, we are used to putting technologies, technical solutions, innovation in our cars. But FF has two basic features. One, it is a true Ferrari. So it required from our engineers that they found technical solutions and innovations to achieve certain performance. I think that Mr. Galliera already showed you the characteristics of the car. So the project was successful from this point of view. On the other hand, we also had to look for solutions, new solutions and innovations to be able to make this car into a usable car. The usability of this car is great. It's the first Ferrari which has great usability. You can use it independently of the weather and also ground conditions. It was therefore a challenging project. Concerning the performance, there's no need to reiterate that acceleration from 0 to 100 kilometers an hour in 3.7 seconds is the best value on the market. Weight to power ratio 2.7 per HP is really great. And really, braking distance 35 meters from 100 to 0 kilometers an hour. So in 2.3 seconds, you just stop. You can brake from 100 to 0 kilometers an hour. As I was saying, this car features sports characteristics, so it's a true Ferrari, but on the other hand, it's usable under all conditions. The innovations that I'm going to show you component by component always have this dual characteristic. On the one hand, performance, and on the one hand, usability. Let's start from the engine. The engine is our classic 12-cylinder engine. It's the first engine of a new 12-cylinder direct injection, high-pressure family, 660 HP at 8,000 revs, which means 105 HP per liter, and a torque of 685 Newton meter at 6,000 revs, which means really the best on the market. And performance, 660 HP at 8,000 revs is possible because, you know, we thought that the usability of the car was to be up to 8,000 revs for better sports character. It's a car that should be used, so it has 500 Newton meters starting from 1,000 revs. Together with direct injection, this condition allows for using the car as a normal or standard sedan. Apart from the engine, the other important feature of FF is architecture. We have kept it as usual for front engine cars. You have 53% of the weight in the rear part, And this is because the engine is behind the front axle. But this is not enough. FF is a car that should be used in normal conditions with two people in the front seats and must have luggage, a certain luggage compartment. Therefore, we have devised a new architecture for this type of performance. The chassis of the FF is a new chassis. It's not something that existed before. We remade it completely in order to ensure this new performance that was required of the car. But there is also another reason. FF has the weight and size of a 612, but has got much more inside. It's got larger back seats. It's got 4x4. It's got more components than 612. So we had to, you know, try and deal with the weight. That's why the architecture and the chassis are different from the previous cars. Furthermore, and this is something we normally do when speaking about safety, FF can be approved officially with the safety criteria of 2015. The new chassis architecture will be like this in the future for all 12-cylinder cars. The first great novelty is a Ferrari with four driving wheels, the four-wheel drive. This project was developed 5-6 years ago when we started to think how to increase our range, our product range. It's a completely new solution which couples with the architectural efficiency of FF. So the 4x4 solution we have devised perfectly fits with the dynamic balance of Ferrari FF. Of course, it was developed for sports performance. There is a launch control logic for snow conditions. So if you want, you can make sport startings also on snow. Then Simone and Benuzzi developed a car that was pleasant to drive on snow too. You saw this in the videotape. We compared FF with other four-wheel drive cars currently on the market, and now we are in conditions to have a positive performance gap. Concerning the four-wheel drive, the solution we have chosen is a unique one. The unit, the four-wheel drive unit, weighs 50% less than other solutions currently available on the marketplace. That's why the car is innovative. And they are fully integrated with the vehicle control logic, the traction control, and the electronic control differential. And this is thanks to the experience of Gestione Sportiva. All the logic systems for the 4x4 control comes from electronic systems that Gestione Sportiva developed about 10 years ago. Some more characteristics of the four-wheel drive system. The system has a control logic. I think you will see it in some videos. In the control system, there is a system that estimates the grip for each tire. So depending on the needs, the system transfers the torque either to the front and rear wheels or on rear wheels, depending on the grip limits. It's a specific and unique logic of Ferrari. It functions because behind this you have an architecture which allows for easy driving and dynamic conditions. You have a 7-speed dual clutch transmission with a twofold goal: to ensure performance, you know, that the gear shifting time is zero with dual clutch because there is continuous torque transmission. On the other hand, you can obtain the best characteristics in gear shifting comfort terms. So you can drive it in a comfortable way or in a different way. Concerning the rest of the chassis, the suspensions are completely new. We have multi-link suspensions on the rear axle so that the maximum torque can be applied to the ground. We have adopted the shock absorbers of third generation. This is the new generation of shock absorbers that we use. They are electronically controlled to be adapted to the driving conditions, and they have the lowest friction possible so as to ensure comfort. Then we have used a third generation of carbon brakes, again, in this case, to obtain exceptional performance. I told you at the beginning that the braking distance of FF is great. With these braking pads and discs in normal driving conditions and not on the right track, the system does not wear out, so it can be kept throughout the life of the car. Other novelties that we have are the tires, of course. We have developed both winter tires and standard tires for this car. They were defined in such a way that, or developed in such a way that the grip is standard, that is the same as in 558, but the rolling resistance is lower than 4%, so less rolling resistance, less consumption. Then concerning fuel consumption, also in FF, we have the system that we presented 1 year ago in California, which is high emissions, low emissions, with start and stop and all the services, the engine services being or functions being electronically controlled so that you can use them when necessary, again, for reducing consumption, so that at the efficiency of the engine, FF has 25% consumption less than the previous model that it replaces. And this is to be in line with something that was said in 2007. As we replace the models, we replace them with new models that have, on average, 30% less consumption. I think this is all as far as I'm concerned in order to show you what the car looks like. And also, as Mr. Montezemolo said before, over and above the efforts that we have made within Ferrari, had we not had our strategic vendors and suppliers, this car would not be as successful. The outcome would not have been this one. So the merit of this car is not only of Ferrari, but also of our partners. Thank you. During the presentations, you repeatedly heard that it is a new, extraordinary, innovative car, a break with the past. And Mr. Filisa has clearly explained why. The technological innovation inside this car is great. However, surprises are not limited to this. Discontinuity with the past is also shown by great work in order to improve the quality of fittings and life on board of the car. All was developed to achieve the top level of exclusivity. Starting from the outer colors, we must say that we have developed new colors. Three are shown here. Rosso Maranello at the center, to my left, gray Abu Dhabi, and to my right, gray Ferromet. But this evening you will see the other three colors: blue America, white Italy, green Racing. in combination with new leathers. Each of these six colors will be combined with completely new leathers to improve the final outcome. Then if we go on board the car, in the interior of the car, there are three basic elements that strike you. The first is roominess. This is not a 2+2 car, but it is absolutely a four-seater car. The second element is the sport character of this car. This is a true Ferrari. It's got the Ferrari DNA. When you go on it, you immediately realize that you are on a Ferrari. The third element is the quality of the materials and the finishings of the fittings. I'd like to suggest that we take a virtual tour through the car. You can accompany me to discover the novelties of this car. First of all, these seats. The seats were developed in a very encompassing way. They're bucket seats, and this is normal for Ferrari, but they are very comfortable. They feature great comfort. In the front seats, two persons taller than 1.95 meters can sit. The surprise comes when you touch the materials, because also concerning the materials, we made something entirely new. So semi-aniline leather was used. It means that it's extremely soft, extremely natural, with extraordinary colors. Then if we move to the driver's seat, if you open the door and sit on the driver's seat, you immediately see the Ferrari DNA, the sport character of the car. And this is shown by a sport type of cockpit, at the center of which you have the steering wheel, which encompasses all the controls and infotainment controls. They are backlit. They can be easily used. Also, the paddle shift is closer to the steering wheel to make it easier to use the paddle shift. All was developed for top performance and safety. Any control can be touched without taking off your hands from the steering wheel. The control panel again reminds one of Ferrari. At the center, the typical rev counter of Ferrari, then to the right and left, two 5-inch screens which give you all the necessary information to drive the car with great performance and safety. Information on the manettino, suspension adjustments, and the possibility of seeing the car in the front and in the back when parking. If you then virtually move towards the center of the dashboard, surprises are again there, because at the center of the dashboard, there is a new infotainment, a brand new infotainment system, absolutely innovative. It keeps up with the most recent technological developments. It has a number of features. First of all, a new graphic system. It's easier to use, by the way. And also, it can be used through the touch screen or vocal controls, voice controls. Again, not to take off your hands from the steering wheel. And it can be integrated with all the most advanced multimedia systems, iPad 4, for example, or Samsung Galaxy. It's got an interface for these multimedia devices, which are the most advanced available in the marketplace. Surprises have not ended yet, because if we move towards the passengers seat, you have something which is brand new in the automotive world, because in this car, in front of the passenger, you can, on the front passenger, you can mount a small screen to share the driving emotions. On this small screen, you can have information on the performance of the car, on the settings, the adjustments. I mean, all this information can make the passengers' driving experience more exciting. Continuing with this virtual tour, let's move to the rear seats. Again, a lot of roominess here. On the rear seats, two adults that are up to 1.95 meters tall can sit. Another innovation for Ferrari, and this is the first Ferrari that has this feature, is the following. You can put two screens on the headrests, giving the rear seat passengers the possibility of watching a film or listening to their favorite music. But the novelties are not all here. You can see that attention to roominess is also visible in the luggage compartment. The boot, the trunk of the FF, has a capacity of 450 liters in standard conditions, and this can be increased up to 800 liters by tilting the two rear seats. This car can really be used under all conditions. Maybe for a long trip, you can load a luggage set. Or you can load your favorite hobbies equipment. You can go skiing, you can go diving. Well, with this short presentation, I've tried to convey to you the big novelties inside this car that make it an extraordinary car on the marketplace, both in terms of performance and versatility.
Thanks for watching the Auto Channel. For more great coverage of all major motor events, visit theautochannel.com, the internet's most complete and comprehensive automotive resource.